Hello and welcome back to DrummerConnection.com. Today we're going to take a look at the 15-stroke roll. Now we've covered a lot of the other rolls in the past, so now we're going to look at the 15-stroke roll. As always, you really have to have your doubles down really well before we start doing this. If you don't have control over them, when you start to break them up and do these different types of rolls, you're really just going to train wreck. So make sure those are nice and solid before you move into this stuff. Also, as always, I like to count and think 16th notes as we're working on these rolls. It gives you a really nice starting point and an ending point in 16th note world, which I think translates really nice when you're behind the kit playing music. So we want to get used to doing that. The 15-stroke roll basically combines a 9-stroke roll and a 7-stroke roll. It's quite similar to the 7 the way that the sticking goes. If you start on the downbeat of the 7, remember you would stop on the of that beat with the left hand. So if you start with the right, with the doubles, the single is the left, like this. 3E and a, 4E and a. Now, the 9-stroke roll started on the beat and ended on the beat. 3E and a, 4E and a, like that. So we simply put those together. You don't stop on beat 2 like you did with the 9. You keep playing through and start actually what would be your 7-stroke roll right there. You put them all together, basically that's a 15-stroke roll. So for a right hand lead, you're starting with the right, you're going to play through beat 1, into beat 2, and then stop on the of beat 2 with the left. 3E and a, 4E and a. 3, 4. Even slower. 3, 4. Same deal as always, once the hands are comfortable, let's jump behind the kit and get the feet involved. I like quarter notes on the bass drum, upbeats or ands with the left foot on the hi-hat, and let's explore the 15-stroke roll. So that's the 15-stroke roll. Pretty basic. I really recommend that you guys check out all the rudiments out there. At least spend enough time on each one to get comfortable with it, get inside the sticking, see what's going on. Then when you get behind the kit, you have a huge library of ideas and things that you can pull off because you checked out your rudiments. See you next time.